begin, remove the spring on the side of the cartridge. Unlock the spring on the other side of the cartridge. The top half of the spring will stay under the blue handle. Extract the two pins using small pliers. They're in this position. Note the different pin size. The short pin is on the left side. The long pin is on the right side. Separate the two halves of the cartridge. Toner section and drum section. Remove the metal pin indicated by the red arrow. Using a small hammer and a screwdriver, punch the drum pin halfway through its hub. Rotate the drum so the pin is visible. Extract the pin using pliers. These pins are in tight and are hard to remove. Remove the drum axle. Remove the drum. Remove the two screws. Remove the support plate. Remove the developer cylinder with its bushings. If you want to remove the doctor blade, remove its two screws. But this blade is glued and easily to be warped or damaged. I suggest you not to remove it. Clean the edge of the metal blade with isopropyl alcohol. Make attention not to damage the Smile-R sealing blade. Clean out the remaining toner from the cartridge. It's better to use compressed air. If possible, use a toner workstation. Cleaning all the old toner is very important. The toner left in the cartridge is mostly waste toner. And if you have two different type of toner in the cartridge at the same time, the quality will be compromised. You can also clean the cartridge at open air. The best you clean the cartridge, the best quality it'll have. Do not breathe the toner dust. Clean the developer cylinder with isopropyl alcohol. The developer cylinder carries the toner from the supply chamber to the drum. Be careful not to damage the recovery blade that is located next to the wiper blade. If this blade is bent in any way, the cartridge will leak. Install the developer cylinder. Move the cylinder until it's fully seated in the driver gear. Install the end cap and the two screws. In this cartridge, there is no refill hole. Drill a hole in this position. Fill the cartridge with toner. The gram load is 175 grams for the black and 135 grams for the colors. Use a tape to close the refill hole. Turn the roller by hand several times to make sure it's correctly installed. Clean the charge roller with water. The charge roller, place the initial charge on the drum, as well as erase the residual charge at the end of the cycle. Lubricate the drum with toner, or the wiper blade may damage it. It's better to replace the drum. But if you want to reuse it, here you'll find instructions on how to clean a drum. Install the drum in the cartridge. Slide the drum axle into the drum. Align the drum hub and axle so that the holes line up. Insert the metal pin and tape it into place. Place the toner section on the drum section. Reinstall the two pins. Install the two springs. This cartridge is a chip. It has to be replaced every time you refill the cartridge. Using a small blade, carefully insert the blade under the chip and lift it out. Insert the new chip. Apply a small amount of glue under the chip. Allow the glue to dry before testing the cartridge. And the work is done.